For breakfast and for talking to us in hashtag for breakfast, we are back, and today we're talking about the business of makeup. And yes, I have just a little makeup, but after what I've seen, it's like showing up when you're underdressed. That's how I feel for my face. Like everybody here looks all glam. I'm allowing everyone to introduce themselves. So yourself and all of you, so we'll start with here. Introduce yourself.
Okay, good morning. My name is Rhema Akabuoga, and I'm the lead makeup artist for House of Tara International.
All right.
Hi, my name is Priscilla. I am a makeup artist and I stand for Urembo Creations.
And my name is Ruth, Kinuthia. I am founder and head makeup artist at Makeup by Ruthie.
All right, awesome. We'll know your models a little bit later on as well. But I guess we'll start with, because today we'll talk about the business of makeup. I guess I'll start from there now, coming back this way. And how did this start for you guys? The business of what attracted you to start doing makeup?
So for me, I've been in the modeling industry for quite a while, I think 7 years now.
Okay.
So once I started modeling and the beauty industry and the fashion industry, it really intrigued me.
Mm-hmm.
And because I've always been artistic, for me it was really just a natural progression into makeup.
Right.
Because we always have makeup all the time on the runway, on pageant.
Mm-hmm.
So when I transitioned out of modeling, for me beauty and makeup was the next best place.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All right, what about for Urembo?
Well, I've always been a makeup artist, a makeup person, let's say.
Mm-hmm.
I've grown up in a house full of girls, so you can imagine.
Yeah.
Like, there's so much makeup all over. There's like shadows all over. And
mm-hmm.
I developed the interest from quite a young age,
right.
And I really love it. So how I started, well, a friend just asked me to do their makeup, and I was like, I don't know how to do it. They're like, but you do yours so well.
Right.
And that's how it actually started.
So you just use what you do on your face and...
Yeah, it just started like that, because I really loved it, but I never really knew it was something that I could do as a career.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All right, awesome. How about you? I'm sure you have some backup about Tara and everything. How
yeah.
you got involved with them as well?
Okay, House of Tara started makeup over 18 years ago
mm-hmm.
as an indigenous beauty company. We started doing just bridal makeup. At the time we started, the industry did not exist in Nigeria. So we started with makeup, then we branched out into having our own products, which we use in empowering young women to become financially independent. We also have our makeup school where we train makeup artists to
mm-hmm.
also grow the industry, and so that we have more people doing makeup all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just a natural progression for House of Tara to come to Kenya
mm-hmm.
and to have a branch here in Kenya.
All right, awesome. So I guess there are different models here, and I'll just allow you to explain, you know, what's going on the face, and also
mm-hmm.
make sure you make it as layman as possible, because there are men watching.
Yeah.
And there's a man right here.
Mm-hmm.
If you say eyeshadow, I might put the shadow of the eye. I don't know. So just tell me exactly what's going on. So I guess we'll start with her.
Okay, so basically we've just done half of her face. We're just working on it before we had to come in.
Mm-hmm.
So what she has on is her foundation, which is supposed to be the base for the skin. Basically, we believe that if your skin looks beautiful and flawless, every other thing would fall in place.
Okay.
The next best thing with makeup is the eyebrows. The eyebrows have to speak a certain kind of language.
Eyebrows on fleek.
Mm.
Exactly, that is. Eyebrows on fleek. So when the eyebrows are on fleek, every other thing just works.
Uh-huh.
What we're working with here is just a little glam look, something she could wear for the nighttime,
okay.
because we have the glitter eyes, which is just a new trend in makeup, basically.
Mm-hmm.
So just make the eyes sparkle and dazzle.
Mm-hmm. So this is good for the night, then?
It will work for the night. If she goes to work wearing this,
yeah,
during the day going to the bank, there will be problems.
All right.
Yeah.
All right.
What I have on my model is just a simple day look, no eyeshadow really. Okay, you can put eyeshadow if you want during the day, but this is a very easy look.
Mm-hmm.
When you wake up and you have to rush somewhere,
mm-hmm.
you can easily do this. It will take like 3 to 5 minutes and you'll be good to go.
Mm-hmm.
So she has foundation and her eyebrows are done. She has her lashes and the cat eye. It's actually, if you put a cat eye, it makes your work very easy because you don't have to put so much and your eyes just... The cat eye is you use a black liner,
okay.
a liquid liner. You can use a gel, there are many.
Mm-hmm.
It depends on your preference. So it's this black line, please look down. It's this line that we have above her eyes.
Mm-hmm.
So why it's called a cat eye? It's because of the illusion it gives, because like the cat eyes, Chinese kind of eyes.
All right, the Chinese kind.
So it makes your eyes pop a little bit more
mm-hmm.
if you have nothing else to do and you really have to rush somewhere.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Yeah.
And What about you?
So this is just your really natural bare look for ladies who do not even know how to do makeup a lot. Mm-hmm. Because there are many ladies who, when they see a lot of makeup, they get confused and they don't know what to do. So this is your 5-minute makeup routine every morning. Mm. So what I've done is that I've primed her face. I used a bit of a mattifying primer. That way, okay, because of okay, really.
Yeah, no, no. It sounds like we're in church. Mattify the Lord. Mattify primer.
So for ladies with oily skin, and I know that many ladies with oily skin, mm-hmm. that's how you get the shine off. Mm-hmm. So okay. I did her foundation, concealer under her eyes, just framed her eyebrows really well, and a bit of lip gloss, and she's good to go. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So this is just for...
This is your everyday look when you're rushing out into the office. I hope we'll get some time to do a bit more. If mm-hmm. we do, I will accentuate it. But this is your basic look for mm-hmm. ladies who do not wear a lot of makeup. Mm-hmm.
I guess you can start as we go on with the conversation, and then, you know, yeah. we'll pick it up as we move on as well. So I guess I'll go back to... Priscilla, mm-hmm. and also ask what are some of the misconceptions that you find that people have just about makeup? Because there kuna watu wanaweka makeup alafu inaisha, the guys who put makeup in the morning and it stays the whole day. Mm-hmm. What is like the basics that you can advise okay. people and how to just make their makeup last? And then the guys, people who have seen, ladies don't kill me, who wear lipstick and then it's cracked all over.
Okay.
Yeah.
So first of all, people have a misconception about makeup. That is, I can blame that on maybe you have done it the wrong way, maybe you have used the wrong product.
Okay.
So you end up having this perception that makeup is not good, makeup doesn't last, makeup makes me look cakey and
right.
feel.
So cakey
like
is the...
Cakey is that feeling like your face is just so full and heavy.
Come
up on a matope, you know, something like that. So that's one of the misconceptions. That's one of the reasons why many people don't prefer to do makeup. Mm. So what you can do, first I would advise you get good products. If you use good quality products, then you will not have a problem with your makeup lasting the whole day. Mm. And then we have primers. You see, when you put a primer before you start putting on your makeup has something to hold on to. Mm-hmm. So it will end up lasting longer than you actually it would on a normal basis. Mm. And then when you're finishing, if you've done your foundation and your concealer and everything else, you just take a setting spray and you apply on top. They're different. I can see House of Tara, they have theirs. There's a MAC setting spray. I have mine. This is an e.l.f. setting spray. You just spray on top, like after you've done your makeup, like something like that, from afar, just mm. from a distance, and it actually sets in your makeup and you look really nice and natural. It helps a lot to keep your makeup to help your makeup stay the whole day and look as natural as it possibly can be.
Mm-hmm. I saw a question on Twitter, somebody asking you before I go to this side, how do napaka mafuta kwanza, do I apply it on dry skin?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What you should do when you start to apply your makeup, it's good to moisturize your skin. And I also like to tell ladies, you just don't need a bunch of products. Skincare is very important. Mm. You need to start by taking care of your skin before you can put on anything else and expect it to look really nice. Mm. You have to drink water, you have to take vegetables, you have to take a lot of fruit. It's very important because true beauty starts from within. Mm-hmm. So the moment you're inside, you're okay, then your face will have a natural glow. Mm-hmm. That's why when you take makeup and now apply it, it'll be easy for you. Mm-hmm. It's like when you're painting, well, you have to prime it first, you have to do so much, you have to fill in if there are any cracks. Then after that, you'll definitely get good results. Mm-hmm. So I advise people to do a lot of skincare. It's very important. Then after that, now you can start with the priming and everything else slowly. Then you'll get there. But makeup is not complicated. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right. So I allow you to do any enhancements you need to do as you walk us through what you're doing right now.
Okay. Basically, now we're working on her eyebrows. We're trying mm-hmm. to define and accentuate the eyebrows. People imagine that the eyebrow is like a very complicated art, but it's very easy. Mm-hmm. All you have to do is start from the arch. Mm-hmm. When you work from the arch, which is the high point where you have the brow bone, just create a curve. Think about it like a crescent. Create a curve. Then when you get to the top, you rise and then you fall. Mm-hmm. So makeup is actually very easy. It's just about committing yourself to doing it right. Mm-hmm. And now you can learn makeup every day and you can learn makeup every time.
Right.
So it makes it very easy for you to wear.
Uh-huh. And the eyebrows also, there's a lot of memes even that go around and tweet about eyebrows and so it's good that you've explained what that is. But then again, someone would ask how much then is too much. The guys who put very thick ones, the guys who put like just a line. Yeah. Is it preference or is there like, is that depending on...
Makeup, there's a rule of thumb. The rule of thumb says that you work with the natural growth pattern of the hair.
Okay.
So that means that if your brows are natural, you have a wide, the width is wide, then you follow what you have. If it is thin, then you follow what you have. It would look very ridiculous if you have very thin brows and you decide to give it like double deckers, layering on top and layering at the bottom, and then you have the highlights and the concealers going everywhere. So the rule of thumb is follow the natural growth pattern and the natural width of your brows.
Okay. All right. Okay, so then again, we'll go to Ruthie over there. And so what are you doing, Ruthie?
So what I want to do is I want to apply a shadow. Because she's dressed like she's going to the office.
Okay.
So I want to apply eyeshadow that would work if she was going to the office.
Mm-hmm.
So one of the things that most ladies would not know is that you need to wear an eyeshadow primer, which is what I've just put on her eyebrows, I mean on her eyelid, before I put on the eyeshadow, because it holds on to the eyeshadow. There are many ladies who go through the day and they wonder why, for example, by noon, their eyeshadow is lost, like they cannot see it. Or it's either fallen or the particles have fallen under the eye. That happens a lot. It's because they don't prime the eyelid.
Okay.
So I've put on the primer. Now I'm just going to put on a very nice neutral shade that she can go to work with.
So this is, again, like you said, for the office look.
Yes. This is more office, a bit more professional, very polished.
All right. Cool. And Priscilla here has been drawing, doing stuff. What have you been doing over there?
Well, I have put two different liners under her eyes. This is, this side has black and this side has blue. The reason I have this is to explain, most people, I've seen locally, most Kenyans just like doing the black. But I really like to advise that you should just try and do something something different. If you have blue aqua colors, any aqua colors, make your eyes a bit more, more brighter. Because you find it's like the reflection of water. So your eyes don't look tired, and when you have bloodshot eyes, it really works well when you have these aqua colors and like having black, because they cut you short before you get to notice, you know, your eyes look bloodshot. There's something there to just distract you. It's very important, and it's really nice if you're, if it's for weddings and places where you'll be in front of so many people but you're from a distance, it helps your eyes more look brighter than normal, unlike black. And then the other disadvantage with black liners, if people use it for so long, you tend to have a permanent dark stain under your eyes. So whether you have put it or not, someone just asks, oh, is your eyeliner smudged or is something wrong? Like, what's wrong with your eyes?
Right.
So it is actually not so good to stick to one particular color for a very long time, because you end up getting a permanent stain, especially if you don't use makeup removers when you're removing your makeup. So it's very important. But then again, I'm not saying you don't use removers when you're removing your makeup. It's very important to follow the procedures. You don't sleep with makeup. You don't. You should always make sure you use the best makeup removers to remove your makeup. That way you don't have permanent stains under your eyes, because no one needs that. No one wants eye bags. No one wants stains under their eyes. No one wants their eyes to look bloodshot. So it's very important to just do the small things that can save you a lot.
All right, awesome.
Yes.
So I guess I'll ask you about the skin, like, is the skin tone in relation to what the product that you're supposed to use? How do you know that this is my right tone? Because you see, you see people who look very bright with makeup, and then after when they remove it, they become my color.
Yes, so basically, with makeup, makeup is a science,
right?
And makeup is also an art. You need to understand the science, but basically as well, makeup is also common sense.
Right.
You need to think about what you're doing and why you're doing what you're doing. If you're dark skinned, it means that there's something called color theory, very advanced. We don't go into that today. But if you're dark skinned, the best place for you to test, the easiest way for you to figure out what foundation to use is to swatch it against your jawline.
Okay.
If you blend the foundation against your jawline, you're comparing with your face and your neck, because you want to look like you are even. You don't want a case where you look like the neck is different from the face and then it was like the head was photoshopped on the body. You want an even tone. So you swatch your foundation against the jawline, comparing it with your face and your neck. If it looks too light, it's not your shade. If it looks too dark, it's not your shade. If it blends in and you can't really tell where it starts and where your skin finishes, that's the right foundation to work with. And you're better off working with tones that work. Now I know that the confusion now came in when we now had the advent of contouring, where you're trying to highlight and then low light. People got a little confused. But still stick to the rule of color. When you're dark skinned, use things that have lots of reddish and orangey base. When you're light-skinned, use products that have an olivey base. Mm. So they look almost like they're olives. Warm, that kind of color. Right, use those right. kind of colors. Mm. Just that way it just works for you.
Mm-hmm. All right, awesome. I can see some of your feedback using the hashtag Power Breakfast. I'll just sample some of them. and I'll sample a good mix. No relation, of course, to any of you who are here.
Okay.
So there are different comments. There are people who are saying, somebody's, Eric Koigi says, I big up Priscilla Ndanu over here, and she's saying that you never disappoint. Abdi Mohakan 5 says, I don't think men should wear makeup. That's something that we're going to discuss shortly. And then somebody says, with makeup lady, that is Paul underscore 2018, says, with makeup ladies look lovely. But then I without makeup they don't. Interesting. And then there's a question that I'll ask also as well later on. And yeah, so let's talk about the men and makeup, because I know all these are ladies, and right now there are some men who want to know about makeup. Like, so what if you're a man or a dude, what exactly do you do? I guess we'll start with Ruthie.
Okay. I think makeup serves its purpose. It has a purpose behind it. So men could wear makeup, especially if, for example, they're doing a photo shoot or they're on TV. Thank like you. You, you're doing an interview.
Thank you very much.
Many people may not know the light may be really harsh. So if you don't have makeup on, you may end up looking very uneven or very shiny because the lights are also hot. So as long as it serves its purpose, I think it's okay. Mm. Of course, you know, the way the world has grown and metrosexuals emerging, there are men, and also it depends on culture. Mm. I know in Europe, in the Western world, they wear makeup. Like there are men who wear makeup and it's okay with them because the culture allows it. Mm-hmm. So yeah, it must serve its purpose. That's what I believe.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you just briefly, what you are doing there, I know you're
right. Master. So I've just worked on her eyes.
Okay.
And I've done a bit of eyeliner at the bottom. So I also want to do a top liner and then just work on her lip. Give her a nice bold lip.
So what's your eyeliner?
So eyeliner
kini.
Is this the one
bottom.
Right there.
All right.
That's
then top, what you're explaining, Priscilla.
Exactly.
Yeah. All right. Mm. And then, which is the shadow?
I'm
helping them on here. Eyeshadow, like when
eyeshadow,
you close your
eyes.
Close
your eyes. No, eyeshadow, that eyeshadow.
All right there. Right awesome. There. Good. Yes. Okay. Nice. All right. Okay, so there are another question I saw on Twitter here that I'll just ask also. But basically, I guess I'll go back to Priscilla even as we go back this way. How do you make it? Because you're talking about the business of makeup. How do you stay relevant in the makeup industry? And how do you, what are some of the character traits you need to have to make it in the makeup industry for those who want to join?
Okay, first of all, makeup, the makeup business is not hard, mm-hmm. as people imagine, but you need to be very patient. Mm-hmm. You can't just start doing makeup today and expect that you will have 1 million clients the following day. Patience is key when you want, if you want to be a makeup artist. And then again, you have to be very consistent. Mm-hmm. You have to really practice with so many faces when you're starting out so that you can be able to familiarize yourself with the faces and complexions and skin tones of different people. That way it won't be challenging because... And so if you do my makeup nicely, I'll be able to tell my friend, oh, Mary, she did my makeup really nicely. How about you try her for your wedding? And it goes on and on. So the moment you are very, you're not patient enough, you might actually just lose hope and stop in between. And it, and that's not the way to go. Mm-hmm. You shouldn't stop doing makeup because you want money, but you should start doing makeup because you're really passionate about it. If you're passionate about anything, you will be able to achieve whatever it is you want to do.
Right.
So don't do anything. Don't do makeup for the money. Do it for passion. Because if you do it for the money, your patience will run out, first of all. And if it runs out, then you can't do anything else. Mm-hmm. So it's possible. But you need to be very patient. You need to be very consistent. Your work needs to be very good. And you need to also learn to understand and deal with different clients.
Mm-hmm.
You meet ladies especially, and people have different characters. So you need to be able to deal with all of them and accommodate everyone. And your aim is to make them look good at the end of the day. Mm-hmm. Anything else does not really matter.
All right. So we have a question here on Twitter. Alexis Tande or Alexis underscore Tande is asking, do they offer any makeup classes? And I know House of Tar is here all the way from Nigeria to do what you're calling a master class.
Yeah.
And I guess I'll allow the lady there to also talk about what the masterclass is about. I know Ruthie mm-hmm. attended a masterclass as well back then. So we just want you to talk about it. Good. Right, so tell us about the masterclass and what House of Talent is doing. And also introduce yourself.
Okay, my name's Ada Iwugo. I'm the commercial director of House of Tara. And thank you for having us on the show, by the way. So we're in Kenya this week, and we've been here already for about 2 weeks. We're here for another 2.5 weeks. Tomorrow and Saturday, we have a beauty entrepreneurship masterclass. And this is a really, really exciting class that we have here in Kenya, where women can come and not only learn the art and the skill of makeup, but they also learn, really, the business of makeup. Mm-hmm. Like the lady was saying before, it's something that starts with a passion, but there's no better way to make money than turning your passion into business. And so you take... You take both boxes.
So who can come? I know do guys already established can come, or people who want to learn about it, who is eligible to come to the class?
It's pretty much anyone that can come to the class. So whether you've started training as a makeup artist, or you're actually already established and you want to go to the next level, and you just want to network and meet people and then really hear from very strategic business people how to take your business forward, I think that this masterclass really is for you. And I wouldn't just limit it to beauty professionals as well. I think anyone in the creative industry who's just wondering, how do I really take this to the next level? How do I structure my business? What are the ethics I should have in my business? How do I impact those around me? Should definitely come for the class. Mm-hmm. So the first day, you have lots of business leaders, so you have about 4 or 5 really successful business leaders who will come and share their stories with you, share tips and tricks with you as to how you really grow and develop a business. And then on the second day, we now have the masterclass, which is about the skill and the art of makeup. We have our lead artist, who you met earlier on today, who will actually take the class. And this is, she's a renowned makeup artist, has worked on lots of movie sets, magazine covers, done lots of TV shows, so she's got lots to share with you. I think you heard her talk about color theory, all the complex things that you may not understand, you know, contouring, doing bridal looks as well. You also get to learn a lot about the products. You'll learn that our products are all natural, they're mineral-based, they do not contain any bleaching agents whatsoever. And you also learn how to sell these products to other women who may need it, and also how to teach these women how to do their makeup.
Mm-hmm. All right, okay. Thank you very much. And of course, I hopefully everybody can be part of that as well. So, of course...
We're exploding.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
Okay.
Sorry.
So that you have all the details. Yeah. Let me just try and find the information myself. Okay, so it's holding at the Louis Museum, okay, and it's tomorrow, it starts at 8:30 a.m. Right. And it finishes at 6 p.m. And also again, on Saturday, it's 10,000 Kenyan shillings. If you'd like to register for the class, if you go to www.houseofterra.com/kenya.com, and then you can register. Otherwise, you can pay at the door as well.
All right.
Okay.
Awesome.
Thank you.
All right. So, thank you very much. I guess also most of the people on Twitter ask when I talk about Kuskia Sauti and Model, so I just allow them to introduce themselves.
Okay. So, my name is Naserian. I am the co-founder of Pretty Faces by Naserian, the official House of Tara distributor in Kenya. Mm-hmm. And so we are here to push their beauty entrepreneurship masterclass and to just show people how to start their own businesses. Mm. Yes.
All right.
I'm Mary, model Urembo Creations.
All right.
Hi, everyone. I'm Mathu Nyendo, a makeup artist as well, and makeup by Ruthie.
Mm-hmm. All right, so I guess we'll do a last wrap. I see this, and Naserian here looks like Two-Face. She has two faces. I'll allow you to explain to us what's going on both sides, and then Priscilla will do hers as well, and then I see Ruth is also wrapping up as well. So I guess we'll start with you.
Okay, so what we've done now, we've applied the eyeshadow and the glitter to the other side of the eye.
Okay.
Remember the first time we came to Kenya, the ladies were like, oh, the glitter is real, it's not Photoshop. And I'm like, oh, actually, it's actually real. So the actually real glitter pigment,
right.
You put it on with the glitter glue, stick it onto the eyes. But you have to be very careful because the glue has film as well.
Mm-hmm.
So you put it on, and then we created a little bit of a smoky effect
mm-hmm.
by darkening her eyes with a little bit of powder and a dark eyeshadow. And then she has mascara on the top and the bottom lid. So we're just finishing her foundation there. I'm going to put on the blush and the bronzer, and then
mm-hmm.
she's going to glow, and she's party ready.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Party ready.
Party ready.
This is for the party. All right. Priscilla?
Her eyes are now both aqua.
All right.
I've gotten rid of the black and I've added a bit of bronzer.
Mm-hmm.
I prefer bronzer to blush. Okay, it depends. It's a personal thing.
Mm-hmm.
So a bit of bronzer, and I've put just a little bit of gloss on her lips, but in the middle part of her lips. When you put gloss, it's best not to spread it all around the lips,
okay.
But you just concentrate on the center. That way your lips don't look wider than they ought to be.
Okay.
Yes.
Right. Hey, there's a lot of science in this stuff. All right. Then say this is a look for...
This could work for weekend.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Ruthie?
Yes. So I think we're more or less done. What I did her eyeshadow really quickly. I put a darker shade right at the edge and a brighter shade right in the inner corner, because a brighter shade opens up the eye. Darker shades make something look smaller. And then I have done a very mild contour and a bit of bronzer.
Mm-hmm.
Bronzer just gives you that sun-kissed look,
okay.
You know, even if the weather is dull.
Okay.
Exactly.
Now I know what it is.
And then the quickest way to look made up without doing too much is a bold lip color.
Mm-hmm.
So I've given her a very nice ombre-ed maroon lip color.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really deep at the edges and then slightly lighter as it comes to the center.
Mm-hmm. All right, cool.
Right.
So I guess at this point, I'll also allow each one of you to have, there are so many questions of how can we get in touch with them. So how can you guys get in touch with you guys, maybe on social media, as the last bit, even as we wrap up.
Okay, so you can get in touch with me on Facebook. That's Makeup by Ruthie55. Instagram, that's make_up by Ruthie. Or Twitter, Makeup by Ruthie. Or ruth.kinuthia@makeupbyruthie.com. That's
right.
My email.
Okay.
I'm Priscilla Ndanu on Facebook. Mm-hmm. I also have a page called Urembo Creations. Mm-hmm. on Facebook. And on Instagram, I am Urembo_Creations. They're all small, not in caps. And then I have a number, 0702-452245.
Mm-hmm.
And there's an email, urembocreations7@gmail.com.
Mm-hmm.
So feel free to holla.
Kwa hiyo number, tunaomba tafadhali ikuwe kazi peke yake.
Ni kazi tu.
Kazi peke yake.
Okay, so on Instagram we are houseoftara_intl or houseoftaraKE, and on Facebook and Twitter we are houseoftara.
Mm-hmm.
At House of Tara.
All right.
Yes.
Okay. So, of course, we'd like to thank you guys for coming. Of course, you've heard
thank
all about them, and you've also heard, you know, the way you can get in touch with the masterclass. More details, you can follow them on their handles, get more details on that as well. It's a class that you really want to go to. Ruthie, my dear, congratulations for your award.
Thank you.
Tell us what the award was.
So, it's a Kenya Fashion Awards. I won Makeup Artist of the Year 2016.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Congratulations for that.
Thank you.
All right. So, thank you guys as well. Thank you to our beautiful models for coming through as well, and thank you for talking to us using the hashtag Power Breakfast. It's always a pleasure to read your feedback. I know you could not sample all of them, but again, thank you so much. Again, also remember today being Thursday, opinion contest later on at Citizen TV Kenya will give you the details of what exactly it is you want to know. Remember to download the Citizen TV app. It is absolutely free on App Store and iOS. You'll be able to get the latest news there. You can also stream if you're on the diaspora, www.citizentv.co.ke/TV. On behalf of Fred Indi Muli and Joy Mudengi, my name is Willis Aburu, reminding you as always that successful people look like you and the great Manchester United. Have a wonderful
day. Thank you.